Hallo, good afternoon, good evening and good morning. Prost. We'll spend a bit of some time on how to develop a pay-as-you-earn table in Excel. So use the Zambia pay-as-you-earn tax table, and this is what we have in here. Anyone who gets between 0 to 3,300 is exempted, not pay anything. Between 3,301 to 4,100 will be taxed first band, 25%. On the second band is 4,101 to 6,200, which is 30%. Which is 30%. Then on the fourth band is 6,000, anything above 6,200. So we'll start with the first, so say total tax. Sum. So in the first band, we know that there's nothing that is going to be taxed in the first band. Whether you get more than $100,000 or less than $1, you should not be taxed in the first band. You're exempted. So then we go to the second band, sorry, we go to the second band, or say equals if. Here we'll do this, we'll say if your salary is greater than your 4,100, which is in the second band, which is the max of the second band, if it is greater, then you find the difference, open bracket, you find the difference between 4,100, which is the max in that particular band, the second band, and the max in the first band times 25%, comma, or else again, open bracket. Your salary minus the max of the maximum in the first band, which is the 3,300 times 25%. So what we'll do here, this is the logic that we are saying. We're saying if you're getting more than 4,100, meaning you can subtract 41 minus 3,300, 25%. Otherwise, if it's less than 4,100 and greater than 3,300, then you say whatever number that you have, your salary, less your 3,300 times 25%. But there's a possibility that you would get more than or less than 3,300 to give you a negative tax here. So I'll put in a formula that should give you a zero. If say, for example, you say 3,200, you get a negative, but this is not what we want. So what do we do? We'll put in just after the equal sign, we'll type max, open bracket, then comma zero, and we do like this. So meaning at any given time, what should be picked in here is a maximum number. So it should be more than zero. This is what it is. So then, if say someone gets 1,200, it's going to show 0. If someone gets 3,299, it's going to show 0. If someone gets 3,301, it's going to show that number there. I guess now you understand why we have brought in maximum in this particular formula. So we go to the third band. So on the third band, to be equals, if again it's the same logic, if the salary here is greater than the maximum in there, if it is greater than the maximum in the third band, if it is true, you set comma, the max in the third band minus the mean in this, minus the max again in the second band times 30%, or else we'll say open bracket, it will be the salary minus the mean, the max in the second band times 30%. So then we are going to put the max again here, boom, comma 0, 0. This is what we're going to have. Then we go to the fourth one, which is very easy. We say equals if salary is greater than 62, it's greater than 62, then we pick the salary minus 62, which is the last in the, which is the max in the third band, times 37.5%, or else we'll have a 0. So when we change to 3,400, this is what is going to be there, to 5,600. So I urge you to just get your payslip and compare. Do create this calculator, PSUN calculator, and compare with the numbers that are sitting on your payslip. Once you do that, confirm whether what we have done is correct. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.